Sage's creation was an American game publisher set up by the president of Hot B at the time to port and publish Hot B games as well as others for the Sega Genesis. The Immortal John Hancock here, and today I have a ranking video talking about an obscure company with some games. Once I mention, at least you're gonna remember a couple of these. I'm having a lot of fun doing these ranking videos, and what I'm doing is I'm taking individual game companies that published games for the Sega Genesis, looking at their library and ranking and reviewing them. And so I'm gonna be using a scoring sheet from S to F to tell you whether or not these are games to go back and revisit. I'm having a lot of fun doing these. The link below if you want to rank this yourself, as well as a link to my other ranking videos I've done for the Sega Genesis. So without further ado, let's get into it. Five games released for the Sega Genesis in the US. And the first one is Crackdown. Now, here is the version of Crackdown in the arcade, and it was published by Sage's creation for the Sega Genesis, a scaled down version of the arcade game. Now, here is the Genesis version. So this is a co-op game, top down. You're one of two special agents, Ben or Andy. And so what you're trying to do is setting bombs, and you're trying to stop an evil scientist that's making artificial life forms. And so this is an actual decent game, and it gets overlooked quite a bit. And another thing for people that don't have a Sega Genesis, this was offered on Sega's recent compilation that was offered on a lot of different modern consoles, including Switch, PS4, and Xbox One. And it's pretty decent. I like it. It's pretty good. It's a little rough around the edges. One thing I don't like is I wish the character moved a little bit faster. And it's not really a run and gun. It's more of like a strafe and gun. But you have a couple different weapons, including a bomb that you can clear the screen. It's kind of a cross between Berserk, Gauntlet, and Gain Ground. I really like it. It's got some decent sound. The challenge in this game is that it can get rather cheap. There's various things that can take you out. And it's not really the enemies that can be super cheap, even though it does get pretty tough as the levels progress. The actual environment can get pretty annoying as you get farther into this game, but I like it. I love that it has two-player co-op. I don't like that a lot of the screen, and if you're not playing with a co-op, there's just a lot of information on the screen. It does help you, but the actual play field is rather small. But otherwise, this is a solid title, and I'm gonna give this a B. I do recommend checking it out. This is a good game. I do think it's worth going back and playing. If you overlook this one, this is not gonna be as popular as some of the other Sega Genesis games. It's gonna be kind of, you know, that more obscure level, you know? This is a game that you probably saw in a rental store and passed up for more popular titles. Go back and play it. It's B, it's good, check it out. This next one, Devilish, The Next Possession. If you were to take like kind of a cult theme and mix it with a breakout style game, you got this. It was a Game Gear game as well. Is Devilish good? I like the graphics. I like breakout style games, but I don't like the ball physics. Now it's got really cool graphics and decent sound, but when it comes down to the gameplay in this game, I was rather disappointed, honestly. For a breakout style game, I think it's lacking a little bit. Now, I do like, it has some unique power-ups. I like the dragon power-up. I love the enemies. I love the kind of the cult theme of this game. It works, that works, but the gameplay is kind of lacking. Some of the bosses are really cool. I love that it has boss fights. It's not a bad game. I just wish that it could be better when it came down to the actual gameplay with the ball physics. You have two sets of paddles, and you know, one of the paddles you can move up and down, and so it's kind of like an offense and defense kind of style with these paddles. Pretty unique, and you can tilt the top paddle left or right to maneuver the ball on the play field. There's power-ups, there is a scoring system, there is co-op. And so, you know what? It's not a bad game. It's rough around the edges, a little bit more rough than some other games I'm gonna show today. It's a C for me. I wish it was a little bit better in terms of physics, but I think there's gonna be fans of this game. I think it's okay. All right, this next game is pretty unique. This was an arcade game by Taito, and that is in Sector X. Here's the arcade game, and as you can see, it's more of kind of almost a cute-em-up. And what Sage's Creation did when they published this for the Sega Genesis is they changed the character, they changed kind of some of the graphics and made it a little bit darker with a darker theme. And so it is a bug shooter, it's a horizontal shooter and average at best. I just really couldn't get into this game as much as I wanted to. You know, I really liked the arcade version. I think the arcade version had a little bit more action, and I did like the graphics a little bit better. Typically, I do like a little bit darker theme, but, you know, to me, it was just kind of meh when it came to the gameplay. It was a little boring. There was some cool bosses. The power-ups are so-so. I love the auto fire. It is an easier shooter, and typically I like those, but I just didn't think there was enough action for this game to be great. It's good. It's a C for me. I think it's all right, but definitely I think there's some other shooters such as Lightning Force I can think of that I'd rather play on the Genesis, especially for a horizontal shooter. Depending on where you grew up, when you grew up, and what you preferred, fighting games evolved quite a bit, especially after Street Fighter II came out, changed everything. Kageki was a fighting game. Some people compare it to Pit Fighter. I almost kind of think it's more like Ring King. But anyways, it is just a bizarre looking and playing game. And it was an arcade port. Here's the arcade version. And as you can see, the Genesis version, it looks a lot like it. It's a little bit different. My biggest issue with this is there just isn't much to it. There's not even a two-player option. Come on. Okay, so there's not a two-player option. There's really just a jump, a jab, and a straight. There's just a couple punch moves with the jump button, and that's it. There's 9 levels. It's pretty straightforward. It's rather boring. I didn't find myself liking this game whatsoever. I didn't like the graphics. I didn't like the gameplay. I think this is just a pretty terrible game. So if you like terrible games, or maybe this was just the one game that you grew up with and maybe you like it, I don't like it. It's an F for me. I don't think this is a good game. I didn't like the arcade and I didn't like this game. So that is a solid F for me and the worst game that they published in my opinion. Now, this is the game that I remember growing up and looking in the back of magazine ads and I saw Shadow Blasters. This actually was heavily advertised in magazines. At least I remember looking at magazines back in the day and seeing this game advertised, Shadow Blasters, and boy, this is a solid title. Now, graphics aren't remarkable, but what's really cool about this is you get to choose your own stage. It is two-player co-op, and what's neat is it's kind of a strategy of like, you have 4 different characters with different abilities, and you have to keep them alive. Once they're dead, they're dead. And so there is a continue feature in this game, and it's fairly easy to beat. I like that about this. It's kind of an action shooter of the games shown today. This is probably my pick for one of the better titles. I enjoyed it. It's got solid gameplay. It's not remarkable. It's not going to break new grounds, but I enjoy playing this. I think it's fun to play with a friend, and I highly recommend it. With the different strategies, especially having 4 different characters, and you get power-ups in the game, and so there's a lot of strategy of pausing the game, selecting another character to keep them alive, and you know, especially when you see a you know, something to help you with life. And so I really like that about this game, and I haven't played this in a while, so when I went back and was checking this game out, I was like, man, that's really fun. I want to play more of this. This is a great title, and it's a B. That's it. That's what I have today. What did you think? Here is the rankings. And remember that you can rank it yourself below. Thank you so much for the ongoing support. I'm having a lot of fun doing these videos and talking about these obscure video games because there's so much out there that people don't know. And people just want to know, hey, is that fun to play? Is that worth going back? Well, hopefully this short list of rather obscure games can make you determine whether or not you want to go back and play any of these. So I want to hear your stories. Did you grow up with any of these games? Comment below, as I always love hearing your stories about playing these games and the memories that you shared of this time of yesteryear in which there was several game companies publishing games. And, you know, I've really enjoyed going back and playing the Sega Genesis library. So hit that like and subscribe button and click the bell as I'm uploading videos every week. You folks are wonderful and beautiful. This is the Immortal John Hancock. Thank you for watching, and you have a good day.